the past 24 years, a teacher for the Hamilton Board of Education has been taking city kids out into the woods to show them how they can see and smell the wonders of nature. On one of their tours, Newsroom 11 went along, and this is what they saw.
Dave Brown is about to give the grade 3 students a lesson on the birds and the bees. That's the birds.
Should we go into the woods and kill things this morning?
No.
And the bees.
Yeah, you're on the right track. This is a wasp or yellow jacket hive.
For 28 years, Brown has taught science for the Hamilton Board of Education. For the last 14 years, he's done it by busing in students from all grades to his portable classroom located on the brink of the Westdale Ravine. He's marched over 100,000 students out of their concrete classrooms into nature's theater.
What?
It's creepy,
is it? Listen. Just listen to the forest.
A bird.
Look how big that tree is. That's an oak tree. Great big one.
Do you have sap trees in here too?
Stay off the edge there. You'll roll down the hill and hit a tree. That'll damage the trees.
Can we go down there?
Yep. Skunk cabbage, yes. Now, skunks don't eat this to fill up or anything. Smell. Why is it called skunk cabbage? Eh? That's bad. Another one?
Can you poke this
eh? And so many of the children that I have come to me, they just don't come in contact with plants and animals or the outdoors usually in their day-to-day life. In fact, sometimes this is the only time, once a year, if it's that. And I like to get kids so that they'll understand how plants and animals fit together, how they all work together in cooperation with the environment, water and the sky and the mud. But on the other hand, I'm not going to save every animal on Earth by doing this either. Like, I know that these youngsters are eventually going to go out hunting and fishing and things like this. You know, I had a little boy the other day who didn't want to go home, and it kind of leaves a little bit of a lump in your throat. Because I wouldn't do what I do if I didn't like children, you know?
Do you remember your favorite teacher? Mine was a grade 6 science teacher by the name of Dave Brown.
And Dave Brown is with us today. And I'm hoping that you'll be able to tell us as parents, when we go for a walk in the woods, some of the things we can look for.
First, the idea that every tree isn't a maple tree and every animal isn't a beaver, I suppose.
Okay, yeah, but that's... And you've even brought
a
tree.
Along
is
a
this
things.
A maple?
I brought along a few things there, yeah.
Is this... This is a maple tree, though, is it?
No,
it
that
isn't.
One's a piece of... This one here is a piece of a cedar tree.
This is
and
a
there's
cedar
a hole
tree.
In it.
That's the kind of thing we as mummies and daddies would point out if our kids didn't
right.
see it first.
But you've got a reason. I wonder what made the hole.
A woodpecker.
A woodpecker. Very good. There, you must have been there 24 years ago.
Okay,
the
but...
The thing is, when you're in the woods, you have to be a bit of a detective.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you're figuring out what did this, what left this mark, why did this happen.
And the
why would the woodpecker go to all the trouble of making that hole?
Well...
After the carpenter ants inside.
Oh, it's there's, carpenter ants, and this is what
the
they were going to be... wanting
right,
to eat.
Right.
Do they actually end up going in there to make a little nest, too?
Oh, only once a year.
Okay.
So once a year, they'll make a hole down in to lay eggs in.
Oh, all right.
The rest of the time is just appetite.
And we have a pile of bones here, is what it looks like to me.
That's
yuck.
All the worldly possessions of a raccoon. A raccoon has
aww.
Passed away, and oh, there's the raccoon skull.
I see.
There. And if you just take that, you can put it together. It's just like a kit that you might buy, maybe. And
no,
you
thanks.
Put it all together, and you would end up with all the parts
well,
of a raccoon.
Well, just lay his night... Yeah. I mean, well,
no,
I'm not supposed to do that, am I?
See,
that's
we're not
bad.
Supposed to do
no.
that with
yeah,
children,
I know.
See.
Bad, Wendy. Okay. And this is?
This is the turtle shell. Not
mm-hmm.
the same turtle that you saw in the clip, but
mm-hmm.
I brought that along to show you because kids have the strangest ideas about turtles lately. I guess we know why from the cartoons and so on.
Mm-hmm.
But the idea that
they
turtles leave their shells.
Uh-huh.
Well, you see, a turtle can't leave its shell because this is the backbone,
oh.
and these are the ribs.
Okay.
So you can't leave your ribs and backbone, and neither can the turtle.
Not and keep walking.
There are no naked turtles running around.
Yeah, the Ninja Turtles are not. Now, what have we got here?
With this even though deer lose their antlers every December,
mm-hmm.
you might think you'd find them all over the ground. They don't.
Because
things start to happen to them, you see. Like the mice eat them, gnaw them, and porcupine. We don't have very many porcupine around Hamilton, but
uh-huh.
other places the mice eat them, too.
Okay. Okay.
And in a few months, they're gone.
And we all know that trees have rings, and that tells us something.
Right, this is something you see, you know, right along the city streets. They're cut down in other places, and there's the center of the growth of the tree. And not only can you tell from the rings how old the tree is, but if the ring's wide, it meant it was a good summer, a wet summer. If it's narrow, it's a dry summer.
Okay.
So you can use that.
So in the last 30 seconds, your words of wisdom to parents would be?
Keep your eyes open and encourage youngsters and never say, ugh.
Never say, ugh, which is what I did.
Okay. I didn't mean that.
Thank you for coming out. There's lots more to say. I appreciated your visit. And we'll be back after this break. One more thing. I know this isn't a beaver, but...
Muskrat. And this is an animal you quite often might see around the botanical gardens here, right here in Hamilton.
Very good. A muskrat. And so what do you say to your children if you see it?
Have a look at it. See it. See what it's eating. Look what it's doing. Look how it dives.
Very good. Okay. And tomorrow on the show, we're going to have a show for cat lovers. Perk up your ears because we have a veterinarian with a practice exclusive to cats and two cat owners who are bringing their cats along with questions that you as a cat owner may have as well. I hope you'll join us tomorrow. And thank you, Dave Brown, for joining us today. Bye for now.
Matlock defends another criminal lawyer who's accused of murdering a mobster. Today at 4, here on CHCH TV 11. But right now, stay tuned for a new attitude coming up next.